Thank you very much. Thanks a lot for inviting us to this special conference. And it's actually nice being here. I've been here, we were just talking about it when I arrived a couple of years ago. I think it was about the same topic. So it's nice being back here. Nice being with you. I was actually thinking about starting with some kind of stillness. And when we did this exercise, just right now, I thought it was really already leading us to there. And we had touched upon this kind of listening I experienced, what it needed in our circle. And it's interesting about, you know, wanting to push something, and then so what's the right thing to do, and how can we be aware of the whole? And that is very much what also Theory U is about. And I use the beamer, I hope it's okay. And just for the ones who know, so my name is Fritz, and I joined the Presencing Institute, now it's 1.5 years ago. But the first time I got to know it was actually also here at a conference from the farmers. It was, I think, 2011. And for the first time, they tried to kind of reinvent the whole conference. And it was to Otto Sharma, and he's the founder of the Presencing Institute. And I'm located at the Lake Constance Bodensee, Überlingen. So some of you might know this area, so it wasn't so far from me to come here. And we're a kind of very global organization. We don't even have a physical office in Europe, but we have an entity in Germany. It's the PI Europe. And I'm one of the two managing directors of this entity. And my colleague is sitting near Berlin. So we are kind of quite a lot in this kind of Zoom thing and meeting physically only a few times. But it's a big community. We have about 50 people in our core team who are working all around the world, and there's a bunch of facilitators around it, and the Presencing Institute has launched different programs, and within the last years, like with the digital programs, more than 200,000 people have joined this program.
You said in the last year?
Huh?
In the last year?
In the last years.
Last years?
Years. Okay. And, this, and we also have programs where we come together and work with, like we do capacity building, but we have workshops, but we also have bigger programs, like with the United Nations or with corporations, organizations. And the whole thing, the Presencing Institute, I mean, the core of it is this Theory U. It's a methodology. It's for profound change. That's what it's about. How can we connect to the emerging future? And before I will tell a little bit more about the background and why we're doing this, I just wants to hear your name. I mean, quite a lot of people, but maybe you can just say your name and the country where you're from. So that I have the connection.
My name is Casinta and I come from Argentina.
I'm Celeste and I come from Argentina too.
My name is Michele, and I'm from here.
I'm Naya, and I come from Italy.
I'm Enrico, and I come from Italy.
I'm Israel, United States.
I'm Rosemary from Egypt.
I'm Asif from Belgium.
I'm Charlie from the United States.
I'm Omer from Israel, and I'm from
my England, and I'm Berlin. My name is Dirk from Belgium.
Joaquin from Germany.
Alright, from here.
From?
Here.
From here, okay.
Yeah. Sylvain from here and Peru. Switzerland and Peru.
I'm Emily, I'm from the States.
I'm Mila, I'm from Russia.
Michael from here.
My name is Hendrik, and I'm also from here.
From Ava, Romania.
Rose from Argentina.
And Masha from New Zealand.
And then from the United States.
Oh, thank you. Wow. It's a very diverse group. That's really special. I mean, yeah. Somehow that's kind of the field we are also working in. So it's really nice to have this kind of diversity here in this room. And so if you look today into the world, what do we face? What do we see? The times we are living in, these are times of disruption. So things that were stable for a long time are kind of breaking apart. And we can see these kind of disruptions kind of everywhere. Or this uncertainty, is it that we look to the nature where we have big crises, if we look into the social field where we can face the big inequality which is becoming more and more. If we look at the pandemic, a kind of flu, we have a war here in Europe, and also, if we look at ourselves, I mean, how are we living in this world? So there are a lot of people who are struggling, looking for what is my purpose, my sense, tending to depression. So there's a lot of disruption going on, and it's becoming more and more. When I grew up, everything felt like, okay, it's just growing and growing and becoming more, very settled. And now all these kind of also systemic things are kind of breaking apart. So we live in a world of uncertainty. But most of the also, if you look at like leadership programs or such of these things, they tell you still a story about stable uncertainty. But how can we live and how can we navigate in these times of disruption and uncertainty? And this was kind of the start also for the work of the Presencing Institute, and that's where we want to dive in a little bit here this afternoon. How to lead in these times, how to connect to the new and find your way through these disruptive times. So if we look at to these changes, how can we respond to things that bring you out of your normal daily routine? And this is always applicable to a kind of a systemic global level, but also to a very personal. So the one thing is we can just kind of freeze and keep on doing the same we did before, or even more of it, you know. this is one habitual way, just not seeing, and if you continue this, or you might even, you know, turn away from it, to distance yourself from what you're seeing. So I was asking like for a copy and got it. You know, I could also say, you know, I didn't get it and what, and distance myself in a way. And we also have it with this make that it degrade again, or you turn into old patterns. You fall back and you kind of distance yourself from the other one, making yourself sort of making the other one smaller and closing up. It's a gesture of closing up.
And if you ever want to check your translation, just tell us, okay?
Yeah.
You're doing great, but I know sometimes things are pretty easy to say.
Thank you.
We've done both during the weekend.
Yeah. That's great, because...
Yeah. You just can't say as much then, just to get people after talk.
It is. So, and the third thing is, you can kind of... Oh, that's interesting. There's something new. That's interesting. I'm opening kind of up, and I'm curious about what's going on. So this is the third way how to respond to change, and that's what we call presence. So,
back to just a second, sorry. What was the third one?
Presence.
Lean
towards
the future.
Uh-huh. Mm. It's the way of, okay, what's going on there?
And then there's the positive feeling, there's something there. You have the emerging future.
There is something there, yes?
Yeah.
In it. So this is now the kind of theoretical background I'm going to show you right now. So if you stay in this kind of downloading mode, just repeating old patterns, that leads you into... I mean, this is what I show you, it's kind of two, if we look into modern society, we have these two social fields, and that's the one we call the kind of absensing part. And the other one, this leaning forward to, is what we call the presencing. So this is the path of creation, and this other one, in the end, leads to destruction. That's what we can experience today in kind of a lot of conflicts and things going on. So if we kind of disconnect, so what do? We close our minds. We have this one truth. You know, we had this with the pandemic or with other things. This is true and this is wrong. It's like that, it is black and white. It's closing your mind. And the next thing is closing your heart. You distance yourself. So we versus them. And that results often out of fear. It's this disconnecting, it has to do with the coldness. And this happens. If you're not aware of it, it's very easy, like in conflicts. You have in your relationship, it can happen very easily. This is well described in conflict theory. You know, this kind of witch circle. It's a circle which turns you upwards, downwards and downwards. If you don't say, okay, stop it. I want to take this other way. And that has to do with this, what I already said, this curiosity, like opening up, being interested. And with a heart opening, try to really understand the other one. Like compassion is the key. Really to feel what is the other one feeling, and the courage to not knowing. To not knowing what will be the next. To not knowing what is right. To really open up also here. So enjoy this little practice we had. It was also like, you couldn't push it, you had to be in this field of awareness. And this is what TRU describes. I mean, it's over the years, it's a whole methodology, because there are certain things which help you to go through this process. And the first thing is like, stop, not just washing, but innehalten, to suspend, and look at the situation. Take a moment, take a breath, like if you're in conflict. Step out of it. And then look at it. What do I really see? What is there? What is in myself? And what is in the world? So not staying in your own mouth, but go outside. And then there is this moment that the new can come, that you have to let go the old. Sometimes you might have an idea, you're kind of stuck to it. And as long as you're stuck to this, the new is not able to come. So there is this moment where you just let go and be open to what will come from the future, which is already present. This is this moment. And then to try it out. Just try it. Do little things, not the big plan, but just try it and then implement it. And this is the circle of creation, and the other one is the circle of destruction. And the one leads to trauma. It's a big thing today. The trauma we create, the collective trauma, but also personal trauma. And the other is the circle of evolution. So this is a kind of evolutionary process we're in. And it's not about I'm here or I'm there, but we're always kind of in between. And if we talk about leadership, what is leadership today? Leadership is, first of all, to notice where am I? In which mode am I? And you can just, in a second, change. Where am I? And then bring me back kind of on track. And this is, again, this is what we can see in the big world. But also on a personal level. I like you, if there are no questions so far, we have this big letting go, you could say, in the world. There are things that are kind of wanting or sort of dying. Things that are emerging, that want to be born. And for me, like just two examples, that an economy built up on competition is old. It's still powerful, and it might get somehow even powerful, but it's old, it's kind of dying. So it's much more what is coming, an economy where we cooperate with each other. What you had here, and where is it already present? Or with education, all these testing and these things, with standardization, that's kind of a thing where if you talk also to people who are really into it, they say, you know, that it's not helping the people to get to their highest potential. Not at all. So it needs a different educational approach. So what I would like you to do now is to talk with, like in three, it's not pairs, what is it?
Triads.
Where do you experience a world that is ending and dying? That's the one question. And the other one is, where do you experience a world that is wanting to be born? And you can first take a little moment to think about it, and then one starts. And make sure that the one who's talking has like 4 minutes, and the other ones are only listening. And then the next one, 4 minutes, and